Really quick, if you're unaware of what playing like a rat is in Tarkov, well, that means you're playing very passive, you're using the audio cues and just being very silent yourself to hear people coming and then catching them off guard. And then after that, you're either gearing up off the people you kill or gearing up off of the people that get left behind by other player fights. Listen, it's a legitimate strategy that a lot of people use. So I figured I'd point you in the direction of some guns that you can use if you plan on using this method or if you ever have to. Let's say you're very, very low on cash. A rat play is the way to go if you're low on cash. But before I do that, let's hear from today's sponsor.
Today's sponsor is me. Can you like the video, please? Thanks.
All right, we'll start with the Vepr Hunter. You can buy the Vepr Hunter from Jaeger directly as long as you have him unlocked and you have him up to loyalty level 2. It's priced pretty competitively in this list as well. It's about a little less than 47,000 rubles. 7.62x51 ammo is powerful stuff. Even four tiers down the list at M80s, they're still very, very good. And what's really nice about the Vepr Hunter is it's easy to just slap an EKP sight on it or even a dovetail sight on it and you're ready to go. And as I said, four tiers down the ammo chart, M80s will still get it done with repeated shots to the chest. But where this gun can really shine is if you have M61s or M62s, or if you happen to have some M993s, that's insane. Now, I'm not saying that you should buy that ammo, because that ammo is going to be insanely expensive, especially M993, that's like 2,000 rubles a round. But if you're playing as a rat, you should be also looting like a rat. Go to the hidden stashes, and oftentimes I'll find M61s or M62s. Sometimes I get lucky and find M993, but you can come up on like 30 or 40 rounds every once in a while. It's pretty often, honestly. And all you gotta do is load up your mags with that and you're ready to go. Now, it's a semi-automatic weapon, so it's not exactly great in close quarters combat. But if you have the 10 round mags, you can get a pretty good spray off. And if you have those M61s or M62s in there, you have a pretty decent shot. M80s, you would just have to get them all on target. And that's gonna be easiest if you're hitting an unsuspecting target, somebody walking around a corner that doesn't know that you're there. All right, enough about that gun. Let's talk about an AK. And it ain't pretty. It's the AKS-74U. Any variant will do. Prepor sells and barters for them. They're pretty easy to get a hold of. The main reason it's on this list is one of the points from the last gun. The inexpensive ammo can get it done. BT ammo is pretty solid. 5.45x39 BT. If you get a bunch of shots on the chest, you're gonna take them down. You'll riddle that armor down pretty quickly. It's not garbage, that's for sure. But like the last gun, you'll often find BS rounds or maybe sometimes even find Igolnik rounds in hidden stashes. Or if you're happening to do your rat runs on reserve, you'll find boxes of BS ammo everywhere. The other thing you find everywhere is cans of Hot Rod, the energy drink. If you take two of those and trade them to Prepor, you get 30 rounds of BS ammo. Now, BS ammo is incredibly powerful against even the most geared players. And obviously so is Igolnik. And so like the last gun, this is what you're looking to do. You're looking to get this good ammo, pack your mags full of that, and go take down the big boys and come out with their gear. And lastly, I mean, it's an AK. So if you want to modify and upgrade as you go along, it's pretty easy to do. There's plenty of attachments. AKS-74Us don't really get very low recoil, even at the top tier of it. But it'll be a lot better than stock, believe me. And if that's something you want to do, then it's very easy and inexpensive to do. All right, now let's talk shotguns. Any shotguns. Well, not any shotguns. Definitely not the TOS. That thing's basically a Nerf gun. But any 12-gauge shotgun is a really valuable rat weapon. Somewhat recently, Battlestate Games buffed shotgun shells. Now, there's other YouTubers that have done extensive testing on this, but all you really need to know is it's pretty viable. Now, if we're talking about buckshot, go for the unmasked face or go for their legs, and I would highly suggest just more so going for their legs. Buckshot isn't gonna get it done through most armors. It just absorbs all of that. Now, if we're talking about Magnum buckshot, you may need to pull your mouse down a lot, but these things can absolutely shred legs. They have high flesh damage. I mean, there's a reason you see big time streamers out there making kitted out Saiga 12s with big old drum mags on it full of just Magnum buckshot, and they're just spraying into people's legs because it really works. It drops PMCs like flies. But also with shotguns, what works really well are slugs. Now, AP-20 slugs are the slugs you're gonna wanna go for. If you don't have Jaeger at level 4 loyalty level, then I wouldn't suggest going to buy them on the market. On the market, they're usually up around 900 rubles per round, whereas if you have Jaeger, you can get them at 196 rubles per round. But these are very, very strong now after Battle State Games buffed them. As I said, there's other YouTubers that have done extensive testing on it. What I can tell you is that it can definitely one-shot the thorax through level 4 armor, and it can two-shot the thorax through level 5 armor. Now, usually it's a little bit, you know, closer ranges, but it's definitely happened. I've done it, and I've had it done to me. Now, the best value I've seen for a shotgun is this one here. It's a mechanic trade you can make. It only takes 2 elite pliers and 1 red screwdriver to get a shotgun that's, you know, decently kitted. You can take off the foregrip that it has and switch that out for something else if you want, but at least you got a sight on it and it's very inexpensive. You could probably get the elite pliers and the screwdriver off the flea market and keep your costs at least under 30k. Okay, now on to more leg meta. The Keter and the Klin, and they're essentially the same weapon. They're very easy to come by with scavs. Scavs have them all the time. You can kill a scav and find it at least once per raid, I would say. You can also get it from your own scav runs pretty often as well. And the great thing that we didn't really mention in the last one, but going with the leg meta, taking out people's legs, is you're saving their armor. You know, when you drop them, you get to pick up their armor, and it's probably a lot better than that pack that you're wearing. Now, all you need to know is the 30-round mags, the SP7 ammo, or you get the RG028 ammo if you can't get SP7, and you just go for the legs. Try to shoot the same leg repeatedly if possible. The way this works is when you black out somebody's leg, any damage that gets taken on that leg, on that blacked out limb, could be arms too, but don't shoot for the arms. That doesn't make any sense. Just go for the legs, it's a lot easier. Any damage taken to that blacked out limb gets then spread across the other parts of the body. So the idea behind it is very high flesh damage, repeated shots to a blacked out limb, you'll eventually zero out their head or their thorax. Probably their head first has less health. So choose the high flesh damage ammo and go to town on their legs. It's a very common method you see people use to try to take down Killa, the interchange scav boss, because he's usually got his Killa armor on. Maybe he doesn't, maybe he has some decent armor on, but also his Killa helmet. You can't really penetrate that super easily, and you also kind of want to get out with that kind of thing. You know, you could sell that for a lot of money. So it's the way I killed Killa for my tasks, and it's very effective against PMCs for sure. Now, these guns offer a very small amount of customizability. You know, there's some that you can get a sight on, there's some that you can get a silencer on. I believe it's one of the Keters, might be the Keter B. But the real idea here is to drop that PMC, then insurance fraud your leg shredder and steal their little 200k AKM that they built all the way up for you. You know what I mean? All right, now last but absolutely not least, the Mosin. I know, you're tired of getting just one-tapped by Mosins, by player scavs, or little rats like this, but listen, it's part of the game right now, and if it's part of the game, utilize it. The Mosin ammo can make even the best armor seem like fishnet shirts, you know? It has very, very high penetration values across the whole ammo chart. And LPS GZH is extremely easy to come by. If you happen to do a scav run with a Mosin, or if you have to kill a scav with a Mosin, that's typically what they're gonna be carrying. Now, if you want to go cheap with it, you can get the Infantry Mosin. It's pretty inexpensive. You can get it from Prapor. If you want to be able to put a sight on your Mosin, then you're going to have to get the standard Mosin. There's 3 different variants. There's the standard Mosin. There's the Mosin that's the same length as the standard Mosin, but can't accept sights. And I think it so says infantry on it. And then there's the full-on infantry carbine Mosin, which is 1 block shorter and also can't accept sights. But the iron sights are very easy to work with. You don't necessarily need to put any kind of sight on it. That's just if you wanted to upgrade it further. And if you happen to find some 7N1 in raid or some 7BT1 or anything above LPS, pick that up, start loading that in. So there you have it. That's 5 rat weapons that are somewhat cheap and very capable of getting you that come up you've been looking for. That Chad with his slick armor, his Alton, his big ol' attack backpack, he's got his AS Val on him. That's all yours for the taking. Just melt his legs off. He'll go report you in the endgame screen just because he's pissed at you. Once again, like the video if you did, or dislike it if you didn't like it. I mean, any kind of interaction helps the YouTube algorithm. And speaking of YouTube, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell so you get the notifications so you don't miss any of the videos. Follow me over on Twitch. I stream Mondays, Thursdays, Fridays. Sometimes I stream on like a Tuesday or a Wednesday. I kind of throw it in there. If you follow me on Twitter, you'll get those kind of updates to know if I'm going to just go live on a random day or if I need to push a stream back or whatever it may be. I also kind of post that in our Discord. You can go join the Discord as well. Those links are all down below in the description. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.
Thank you.